Iowa 3rd District Congresswoman Cindy Axne held an infrastructure roundtable Wednesday morning to discuss funding priorities from the bipartisan infrastructure law. Axne met along with mayors and city officials from Altoona, Clive, Des Moines, Greenfield, Griswold, Johnston, Runnells, Urbandale, and Waukee. Axne says Iowa has already received more than $700 million from the infrastructure law and noted that over the next 5 years, it's expected to deliver at least $100 million to expand access to high-speed internet in rural areas.
I truly believe that with the combination between what you all are doing at local levels, what we're doing at a state level, with the what we're going to be receiving here in Iowa on that broadband connectivity, that between all of those things, we're going to really be able to wrap this up. Finally, honestly, after I don't know how long we've been talking about connectivity for every single person in Iowa, it's been years.
During the roundtable, Griswold City Manager Ted Marciniak thanked Axne for voting in favor of the infrastructure bill, but expressed concern over the possibility of small rural communities getting overlooked during grant allocations. Axne responded by saying that she would look into the possibility of having set-asides for rural towns.
If we do not support rural America, it means we're not supporting urban America either, because rural America is key to success for every city in this country. And we are, rural Iowa is success for Des Moines. I mean, I think about, you know, our John Deere factory and all the good jobs there and producing for farm and agriculture. Well, if we didn't have our farmers out here and across America and the country, where, you know, we need rural. So let me see what we can do, because it's a really good point you bring up.
The hour-long event concluded with Axne thanking all city officials for attending. She explained the importance of local government.
I know how local your jobs are. I know when I go to the grocery store, I get a lot of questions about what things are, and I know you guys do too, constantly. And you're always under the, you know, feeling like there's something else you can be doing for your community. And I know you go to bed thinking that, and I know you wake up thinking that, because I do. And so I'm anxious to work with you all on this. Let's get this as done as quickly as we can. I hope when you leave here today, you please do make those initial connections, even if it's just dropping a voicemail with someone. Start the connection. We'll start the combination of getting these conversations structured with all of you in these individual settings or bigger settings. And let's get after this. Let's do this for Iowa. I'm so thrilled to be here with all of you. I know I couldn't ask for a better group of people to be helping us implement this than the folks that are sitting around here today. So thank you for being here and all you do.
The Infrastructure Investment and Jobs Act is expected to deliver Iowa more than $5 billion over the next 5 years. For the Iowa Agribusiness Radio Network, I'm Brent Barnett.